Welcome back, my friends, to the next episode of Let's Farm. I will just go to the multiplayer because all of my army has trained, and I can just mention that the new 5.1 update is really, really awesome because of the fact that I was able to upgrade three pieces of walls today already without any intention, any effort. I had no training blessing, nothing at all, just only by sideways farming. I went online, I think every 30 minutes, did an attack, and then I saw, okay, my food has increased, my amount of food that much, that I can easily upgrade my walls. 690,000 over here, pretty good. Also, the wall miners have changed. Let's see, guys. I will just kill this wall. Look what they are doing now. Three pieces of damage. Bam. Really awesome. They are crashing a really, really huge wall into... hole into the walls. Wow, these towers are killing my troops very, very rapidly. So in 3 hours my mortar is ready, I think. Let's see later when we are back at my base. When I'm back at my base, I can show you that I'm not initially anymore farming for gold. My first aim will be food if I don't have to do any specific gold upgrades. Because when I can upgrade my walls either for food or for gold, I will definitely change the food. For all of you which have seen my previous video, they just know why. And it's because food is that much easier to farm. Because farms are very, very often, nearly always outside of the base. And so they are really more easy, not available, but reachable for all of your troops. $40,000 in the gold. Okay, the bunches of gold also have quite some gold in it. This player seems to be offline with a lot of food inside his storage building, inside his producing buildings, like farms. So I try to take everything with me which I can without big effort. Oh, come on. That's quite okay, I think. In total we have over here over 800,000 in total, because now we also have to count the food, not only the gold, but I also wasted nearly all of my troops. So let's short retrain, and then you can see, where is it? Over here you can see food or either gold to upgrade, and when I have the opportunity to upgrade with food, I will definitely use it. My mortar is getting ready in 3 hours, and then I think I will go for the last air defense, which will cost me about 5.5 million of gold. So I think in 2 hours I will start my next training blessing. I'm not quite sure whether I will film it or record it for a Let's Farm episode. Probably I also will do it without recording. Yes, and then I get 4 additional free citizens. I will put 4 in the air defense. Yes, then I have to wait and not research anymore in the university if it is lasting for longer. There's also another very, 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 very new and first a situation, and it's the 154th World War of my alliance, and that's the first time I am not participant in the World War. But this is quite not because I don't want it, it's because we have some new active members and the amount of our players was too high. Therefore I decided I will stay outside of the World War to give other players, other new ones, the opportunity to participate. If we would have enough space, I would have taken the opportunity very, very surely, because I always want to World War or to participate. But so I'm not in the World War, and some attacks have been done. Let's look at it. Okay, we see 50 to number 25 of the enemy attacked our 25. Quite okay, two offense collisions. Our elf did enemy number 11. Here we have, oh, 49%, not even the town center. That was bad. Number 33 from the enemy against our 34. 32 against our 33. Don't know which strategy they are following. Very nice. David did enemy number 1, Keko enemy number 4, and Doctor enemy number 3. In total, I think our statistics are a little bit better in this World War. One new attack is still running. Or not one new. Yes, one new attack is running. Okay, we had one black star, 4 5 stars, and one is still running. And very many requests over here. Okay, it seems like a Snoop has rallied without purpose in the end, and therefore all of his troops died. That sounds logically. Otherwise, I don't know whether or how you can get 49%. Wow, that's really sad. 49%, that means one more percent and you would have gained the loot, the war loot, but he did not get anything at all now. We also take some other decisions in our alliance, and that's due to the fact that in many alliances you see that there are some leaders, and after there are only two kinds of alliances which I know. And the first kind of alliance is where you have a specific amount of leaders, and these leaders are not changing anymore. These are guys which are probably got promoted to leaders for their good behave, for activity, communication, experience, whatever. So they are got leaders from a right aspect, and it did not change anymore. And at a specific point, they had about 4, 5, probably 6 or even 7 leaders, and then they talked about and decided to don't take any more players into leader position, because otherwise the alliance will get messed up. And there are too many leaders for too little amount of players. And if you have too many leaders, it's worse than having less leaders. The other kind of alliance is quite this aspect I described to you. When you have an alliance where 20 or even nearly 30 players are leaders and you only have 20 members. And I think both methods are quite not right. So in our alliance, we took some changings. And we promoted and deranked or even ranked down some of our leaders, so that we decided that we will have a term or an order of 3 up to 4 months. And after 3 or 4 months, we will decide which leaders are still active and so helpful to the alliance in leader position, and all other leaders, without being insulting them or being mad about them, we just say if there is some aspect in your life when you are when you have to focus for your real life and don't be able to be active that much in dominations, which situation can really easily happen to all of us, even to me. In 2 years I will go from the university and then I have to give up my leader post or my leader position. And so we decided that the amount of our leaders, which ones are the leaders, will just roll out, and every 3 months we will change and we will only keep the leaders which are quite active and which can help the alliance, so that in total we will have a changing amount of leaders, and this is depending on which leaders are able to be active and help the alliance. Wow, that was very confusing for me to describe, my friends. Sorry for the bad English. Hopefully you understand what I mean. We are doing it probably like electing in politics. There is no one who will be a leader for all times. If you stay active, you can stay a leader, but if you are not active anymore because of your job or whatever, your school, university, studies, then you have to give the leader position up until you get active again. But enough talking, my troops are retraining, and I think nearly all of them, no, are ready. Yes, a huge amount. We can go for the multiplayer. quite no. No. My strategy will be the same. Get the highest amount of loot with the littlest amount of troops to use. Oh, here are some trade goods. I think I will take them. There's also something in the oh, diamond. Diamond. Wow, and leather. Really cool. So, come on. Hmm. What are they? Okay, another request. Let's see for the next attacks which were done. Okay, also on the enemy side. Number 4 took our number 10. It's not quite obvious what the enemy's tactics is. And number 8 took Hadi's number. Our number 8. And only got very, very, very close. 3 stars with 76%. 2% less, and enemy number 8 would only have got 2 stars. That's very cool. And I think we have good chances to win this World War, even when the enemy players are also way higher than we are. Atomic Ages we have over here. Where is it? Over here, for example. And so way stronger troops. Also, I think... Oh, this defensive coalition is quite okay. It's not so strong. This looks quite good. Oh no, the caravans are too spread out. I'm thinking about getting the farms. Yes, I could do. The amount of food is very low over here. Yes. That's probably not so good. Let's take the gold. Thank you. Okay, I think now we can go. Please go for the gold. Yes. Well, not so good in total. That was not very satisfying. I think after this episode, we also probably will be able to upgrade 2 new pieces of wall. And I think in future episodes, we also will be. Because we saw, I'm quite able to farm 5 million of gold when I start about 1 or even 2 million. And the food is even coming in much faster, like you see. I started with both at the same amount, and now I have about 600, nearly 700,000 food more than I have oil. Oh, my university research is ready. Let's see what research next. 4 hours, okay, it is always doubling and tripling the amount of costs, so from 50,000 to 150,000 gold, but that's not the problem. But only 4 hours to go, and because I'm not playing with the loot blessing that often, I think I will go first for the food, skills, research duration. Wow, that was really complicated. 4 hours, and I think it will get ready. Yes, at nearly 1 o'clock in the night, when I will upgrade my mortar. So really perfectly that I can then activate the next stage of research. Any new things in the World War? Yes, another 5 star of the enemies, number 26 against our 31. So I don't think that the enemies have that good strategy. It could be that the enemies have divided up every of our players among them, so that every of the enemies have a specific target. But when I'm looking at the count of glory which we can get from them, I don't think that they are so specialized on the alliance. Nope. But where is the oil? The oil looks quite good. All buildings seem to be empty. So I also don't think that there is much inside. Where's your refinery? Over here we have the refinery. Let's see how much is in it. I don't think very much. 100? Oh, there's something in. Ah, the mortar is really a pain in the ass. Because the troops get interrupted that much. I think I will also go for the... oil wells. The Mauer Sapper is really, really crazy. What also will be very, very, very painful will be the upgrade for the attack helicopters. I don't know whether you have seen my previous video about the 5.1 update, but if you don't have, there's also a new content of the 5.1 update, and that is that helicopters, attack helicopters, are getting splash damage. Like cannons, like upgraded MK tanks, and that's very insane because you can donate them for, I think, 4 troops base? That's ridiculous. Let's see. 8 troops base. Okay, not that less. 8 troops base are quite okay because if they are getting splash damage, they don't have very much damage, but they have a range of 7 and can fly above walls. So if you donate them for the world war, they can really, really be a pain in the ass. I'm very sorry. I read over here that he is sorry, and then I said I would be sorry, but I think it's really painful, and I'm really, really awaiting or wanting to see how strong the attack helicopters were. What a fail of me. 200,000 are quite okay, but the resources are too spread out. I could try, but I'm very, very sure that most of the resources are in here. I don't want to raise to raiders. 300,000 is quite okay. Nah. Little bit frustrating what we are finding for enemies over here, but here is one mill, very exponated, as there is something in. Oh, only 3,000 in the farms, so not very much. I think this attack was quite wasted. I don't know whether we got some trade goods, but I don't think so. Yeah, I have quite wasted. So, how many time is remaining? We are very, very much in front of with food. 30 minutes to go. I think it could be close with our gold. But I have still my my event progress, whatever, rewards. So 500,000 of food and 1.2 million of gold. So we will very, very surely get to the 5 million of gold. Oh, this looks good. Definitely, we have all resources outside, but this cannon tower is a pain in the ass. So kill it first, please. Thank you. Now we can go on. Oh, there are more cannon towers. I didn't recognize. Perfectly, really cool. I think also quite huge amount of raiders wasted, but in total we have over 600,000. Perfect. I already mentioned this aspect before, but now it's getting quite more obvious. I think the upgrade facts or the content that you can upgrade your walls either with food will make the spread between very active and very inactive players far, far huger than it was before. Because players who are quite inactive or not caring about their walls are not upgrading that much more only because you can invest food. Whether to invest 3 million food or even 3 million gold, both of them or both of these resources will be too much for them. And all of the very active players, like I would call myself, for us this is a very huge reward or a gift, and we will hugely, nearly double our amount of progress in walls, and so I think the spread out between inactive and active players will get even higher by this update. I will let myself surprise whether this is right, my anticipation. 300,000, very good, and wow, this is what I wanted to show you guys. To store your resources in this kind is quite wasted because of this. Even with the new raiders, it radars, wall sappers, it gets even way, way easier to crash those kind of walls, because before you very, very precisely had to aim for even this wall path, these T-walls, which are connecting two chambers. But now, because the range of wall sappers got increased, you don't have to aim for this. You can just easily drop them and they will kill everything around. Also, my friend, thank you for your oil. This is very exponated, and over here we have even more, so I can get all of you. Thanks. Oh, we also have some oil in the command post, but I don't want to get because of towers and cannon tower. Quite waste of troops. Perfect amount. Wow. Over 50,000 food for every raider and 700 additional gold. Ah, food. Ah, oil. Come on. I'm very so confused, guys. And I'm very, very excited. Let's see in the world war. Oh, even more stars. I see some very cool stars over here, number 7. Great job, Peter. Also some more higher stars. Where are our higher players? No, no activity of the higher players. Only about 24, 25, 21, 14. But pretty good indeed. In total, we have now 8, 5, 1, 4, 1, 3, 1, 1 star. I think this is obviously very good. Yes, looks quite good this World War, even when I'm not participating. Next World War, I definitely want to participate again. The World War is running for 1 hour, I think, and I'm just already pissed up that I'm not participating. Perfect. Let's see what we can crash the best. Wow. Oh, this... I'm thinking about my World War base. There I have double amount of walls. To have this double walls is getting quite senseless because of the wall sappers, which can crash three walls. So all of you guys, it come to my mind now already first. Not before. If you have double amount of walls, they are quite worthless. Change them because of the new upgrade for the wall sappers. They are very, very senseless now. Wow, all of my sappers are already dead? Why? All of my raiders. Don't know. Very strong defensive buildings. Looting! Ah. I think it's not so easy to get for the buildings. Also, we have empty markets. That means the gold has to be outside. Mm-hmm. I think we also will have about 200,000 food outside. That's quite worth a try. Wow, they are killing my radar so fast. Okay. That was a waste. Clearly fail. Wow. The World War group is also exploding due to the World War. Okay, they are talking about strategies. So I don't think that they are really necessarily needing me in the moment. So I can go on with farming, and I don't have that much time. 70 minutes for additional 1.6 gold and 500 of food. The food will be easy, gold either not. Yes. Very good gold. I can take it. The gold is very exposed. Perfect. Most of the gold is exposed. Come on. Perfect. Wow, that was great. But where is the rest of the gold? Ah, I think in the town center, because of the road. Yeah, there we have some gold. Let's draw the attention. Also something in the command post. Perfect, let's see. We could even crash the town center. Then I don't, then I won't lose any medals. Perfect. So my raiding is more efficient because I don't drop my medals so fast. A few minutes before I started to record, I also got my last achievement, or finished my challenge to farm about 1 billion of food. The 1 billion mark for the gold I finished about 3 or 4 months ago, because of the fact that I always had about full food, and because of the full meals, I could not gain or even loot any more of the resources. I think no new changings in the world war. Yes, nothing has done. I'm very excited to see how the enemy strong attackers are attacking. That enemy number 4 killed our number 10 was quite nothing special. But I'm awaiting enemy number 3, 2 and 1 attacking because of global and atomic troop capacity and troop researchers. When you see West... Wow! Insane walls, my friend! I don't know whether you have paid or upgraded ordinary, but this guy is definitely... Wow. Respect, my friend. All walls level 12 and some even level 13. The gates are higher leveled at level 13 than all of the rest walls. Definitely applause. Respect. What I wanted to mention is, if you see how weather and when they are attacking, how strong and strategically the top enemies are attacking, then you can very, very or pretty much anticipate the ending of the world war and how many stars the enemies will at least in total only be able to get. So you can plan very much better if you see how strong the best enemy attackers are doing. Quite no. That's very, very good, but we have very many of the caravans, now nearly all. That's very sad, inside the walls. But I think, nevertheless, I will go for it. He's so slowed down, come on. Yeah! Oh, there's one another wall between. I didn't see this gate, that was bad. I sent too many raiders. Yes, that was too many. That were too many. Ah, come on. Another not very good attack of me. I'm a little bit sad. Ah. Now I think I nearly have to hurry. 1.1 million of gold to go. My last attacks were quite not that efficient like I hoped. Pretty good, but also very good defended. Nearly the same layout, basically from its structures like miners. One of the mills and markets is outside. Yes, I could do. Also some trade goods available. Not so good, but okay. Oh, we didn't get the mill. Okay, in the mill there's very, very much. I think I will waste one of my sappers. Yes, quite okay. So the first part of the wall we nearly have. Oh, another leather. Very good for the oil blessing. Come on, please. I don't want to end up with 4.9 million gold to go offline, because 4.9 million of gold are that much that you don't have, that I don't see the need to get my over 1 million from the event, but also I cannot up. Oh, I'm perfectly at 1000 medals I didn't see before, but also I can't go offline with 4 million. Come on, please. Wow, that's food. This is food. We have 100. The farms are at the same stages like most of the caravans. This means they have produced nearly the same. We have nearly full empty markets, and we have 130,000 out. So I think 70,000 in the town center, 60,000 gold outside, 60,000 food outside, and 480,000 stored. That was not worth the risk. This is quite okay. Yes, it's definitely okay. Ah, no, the cannon tower. Wow, that was luck. That was lucky. I aimed for the gold, for the oil, because then they are standing very central and instantly having access to the mills. Hopefully, yes, they will get one mill. Perfect. Now I want to trigger them outside. We don't even have to get any more for food. Our next aim should be the gold only, because we have already enough food for one piece of a wall, but I don't want to end up, like I told you, with 4 million. Ah, come on. It's getting so laggy after it's at some time. 4, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, I started with the fifth piece at every side, so I go on for the next side. Fifth piece over here, thank you. Wow, I love it. Upgrading with food. I would not have believed if I would have told myself that before. Let's see in our war base to also upgrade. This war base is particularly senseless now. I don't have to upgrade anymore, because one wall sapper will completely go through this. So don't care about this. I only will go for my other war base. Let's see, where is the next part? Where is the no. Here we have. Quite good. So I think I will put it over here. It looks pretty decent, I have to say. It looks pretty decent with all of these level 12 walls. I also think the level 12 walls are way much prettier or cooler than the level 11 and even than the level 13 ones, which look a little bit, I don't know, poofy. 340,000. No. Wow. That much unprotected oil, I can only tell you thanks, my friend. The backslash, or even this effect of the mortar, is very painful, because your troops are getting slowed down that much when the mortar hits you. That's annoying. These bases, which I'm getting to matchmaked, are all not that bad. Also, not very perfect to loot, but the caravans are moving very good. Ah, it's an offline base, so also 70,000 will be in the town center because of the road bonus, so not useful at all. That's okay. Yes, that's pretty much okay. Okay, I think that's enough. Otherwise, we'll only waste some raiders for the last 40,000 of gold. The amount was also not quite good. 95,000 with 7 raiders. Not effective. I need gold. Nothing else. Aha, come on, please. This base layout is from its build up very okay. But this guy quite not did think about his positions of the mortars. You can all of this four just disable with two places of right places or locations of sabotage. So in total, not very good layout. Ah, quite okay bases. Don't know why. Wow, that's enormous. Let's see. Probably we will have a good shot over here. Come on, trigger all troops. Oh, very getting slowed down due to the Versailles. Come on, Sapper. Thank you. Okay, one market is gone, definitely. Wow, but the both redoubts did severe damage. Oh, there's also very much oil outside. So I also think there will be food outside and gold. I can't decide where to go. Oh, the generals got triggered. And he has Gatling gun defenders for his castle. He's level 176 and has done pretty much of his researches. Pretty many of his researches. What? Ah, sniper tower. That was bad. Come on. Wow. Ah, there are my troops. I think all of them have died. That was a strong base. Lost nearly all of my troops. And it was not worse in total. Little bit above 12,000 per raider. Damn it. I think I fucked up. My training blessing has gone and I am 500,000 away from my aim. Ah, come on. Where's my gold? I have no gold inside. I don't will make it to the second next piece of a wall, I think, if I'm not going very efficient now. Damn it. The caravans are really low. So most will be inside of these markets, which are getting upgraded and therefore look pretty empty. Yes, there's... Wow, very much in. Hopefully that did help. Come on. How can I get more gold? I think by dropping my donated troops. Come on, do the readout, please. Do the readout, then I can rally you. Thanks a lot. And now get in. Perfect. Wow, in total, we nearly saved it up. Over here also, there's the command post. I will just easily kill my my general. Oh, no, what is general doing? No! Oh, that's a fail. I'm so messed up now. No, what the heck? The game is also... Wow, is it laggy? No, come on, General, don't die. Get for the command post. Ah, thank you. Yes, we did it. Very... Why is he not going for the command post? What the heck? Why is he not or she not going for the command post? Ah, that's so ridiculous. Hopefully there's something inside my street. Oh, that was quite a good attack. And in the end, I messed up and wasted a general for nothing. What an awesome and stupid attack of me. I never wasted a general that senseless. Oh, gosh. Ah, nice. There are some thousands inside my caravans. Yes, we have it. Perfect. And I think we can also grab the street or the road. So that we are sure or even safe to be able to get some more multiplayer matches afterwards. Because sometimes when you perfectly get to the score you need and all of the gold you have to invest and you don't have any more reserves after upgrading the building or even the research or whatever, then you don't have even enough gold to start the matchmaking system in the multiplayer. But we can now. We can. Next piece of a wall. Very perfect. Let's take a last short look in the World War, guys. That was an awesome episode because I could upgrade two pieces. Some more attacks. Oh, enemy number 7 also got only 411. So they are attacking quite below their own strength. Number 21, our 28, so also not very spectacular, my friend. I think Enlightenment, if not even Industrial Age, against Gunpowder. He attacked over his own strength. That was quite good. 29 at our 26. So in total, I think it will be an exciting World War. I will watch and be excited about the World War. We'll see us soon, guys. Give me some feedback. Please don't be so lazy. After my last 5.1 update, I only got 2 thumbs up or even likes from over 70 or even 100 viewers. That's very lazy. Sorry, my friends. We'll see you soon. Your domination tips.